Hello everyone, today in this video I will be showing you how to send notifications to Microsoft Teams using Automation Anywhere A360. So before we start our session for the day, I request every one of you to please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification icon so that you can receive all the latest updates and notifications that we keep posting on our YouTube channel. So without any further delay, let us start our session for the day. So our whole video discussion will revolve around how to send notifications to Microsoft Teams using Automation A360. So in this section, let us cover the topics that we will be going to cover in our video discussion. So the first topic that we will be covering is how to add incoming webhook connector to Microsoft Teams. So the next thing after adding the incoming webhook connector is how to configure the incoming webhook so that we can send the notifications to Microsoft Teams. So once the incoming webhook connector is configured, the next thing that we will take a look is the practical implementation of sending the notifications to Microsoft Teams using Automation Anywhere. So let us start our video by seeing how to add incoming webhook connector to Microsoft Teams. So let us start our discussion by the topic that is how to add incoming webhook connector. So in order to add incoming webhook connector, go to your Microsoft Teams and then click on the Teams button. And then once you click on the Teams button, the list of various team names will or the channel names will be available. So in this case, I am taking the example of A360 demo. So you have to click on this A360 demo. And then once you click on the team's name or channel name, then you need to click on the three dots which are present on the top right hand side of the team's channel name. And then you need to click on the connectors button. So once you click on the connectors button, the new page will appear wherein you have to wait for the page to load. And once it is loaded, you need to click on this search button or the search text box. And then over here, you need to add the incoming webhook connector. So once you type in the name, the list, the desired result will be available. So you need to click on this add button. So once you click on this add button, the new page will appear with the incoming webhook connector. And then again click on this add button. So once you click on this add button, the incoming webhook connector would be added. So again click on these three dots, and then again click on the connector. So once you click on the connector tab, again the new page will appear. So now the incoming webhook connector is added. So the next thing that we will take a look is how to configure the incoming webhook. So in order to configure the incoming webhook connector, you need to click on this configure button. So once you click on this configure button, a new page will appear. So over here, you have to provide the name to your incoming webhook and then click on the create button. So I would be giving the name to my incoming webhook connector as add connector. And then I will click on this create button. So once you click on this create button, then the next thing that you need to do is to copy this URL. So to copy this URL, click on this copy button and paste it in a notepad file. So this URL would be used in our API when we will be using or when we will be creating the bot to send the notifications to Microsoft Teams. And then you need to click on this done button after copying the clipboard. After copying the URL to clipboard, then you need to click on the done button. So now the incoming webhook connector is added. So now we will go to our Automation Anywhere in order to build the bot where we'll be sending the notifications to Microsoft Teams using Automation Anywhere. So let us go to Automation Anywhere. So in order to go to Automation Anywhere, you need to log into your, you need to open the URL and then you need to provide your username and password in order to log into Automation Anywhere. So over here, provide the username and password. That is your bot creator credentials. And then click on the login button or press enter after passing the credentials. So once you log into your automation anywhere, you will be redirected to the home page. So over here, once you are redirected to the home page, you need to click on the automation tab. So once you click on the automation tab, you need to click on this create new and then the task bot option in order to create the task bot. So over here, we will define the name to our task bot as send notifications to Microsoft Teams. And then click on create and edit. The name to your task bot can be given as per your choice or convenience. So I have given the name as send notifications to Microsoft Teams. So now over here from the actions dropdown, we will be using the API. So from the actions dropdown, so from the actions dropdown, you need to select the REST Web Services package and drag and drop the post method. So in the post method properties section, copy the URI or the paste the URI which you have copied to the clipboard while configuring the Microsoft Teams connector, that is incoming webhook. So I will paste the URL or the URI that we copied to the notepad file, that is this URI. So once this URI is added, the next thing that you need to do is to add the parameters. So we won't have to give the authentication mode since it is a simple authentication method. So over here in the parameters section, open the curly bracket and close the curly bracket, and in between these curly braces, you need to pass in the text that is which you want to send to your Microsoft Teams. So over here we will write as text. In double quotes, and over here we will pass the colon and then the text that we need to send. So over here I will be sending the text that is hello. This text has been sent from Automation Anywhere bot to Microsoft Teams. And then close the double quotes. And then if you want, you can store the output in a variable. So over here, once you pass in the text, then click on the save button. So over here, I will be storing the text in a dictionary variable. So I would create a dictionary variable that is vResponse. And then I will click on create and select. And then I will click on the save button. So once you click on the save button, now let us run the bot in order to see whether the steps that we have built is performing to our expectation or not. So in order to run the bot, click on the run button. So once you click on the run button, the bot agent service would be invoked and the bot would start to deploy on the machine on which you are running the bot. So let us wait for the bot to start its execution as it is now downloading the dependencies. So we will be back once the bot starts to execute. So as you can see, the bot has started to execute. And now it will be sending the notification to Teams. So it will send the notification to Microsoft Teams. And then we will see whether the text that we have sent has been sent to Teams or not. So now over here, click on the close button as the bot has run successfully. So now we will go to our Microsoft Teams in order to see whether the text that we have written has been sent to Microsoft Teams or not successfully. So over here you can see the text that we written, that the text that we gave has been sent to Microsoft Teams on the channel name that we have added. So this is how you can send the text from Automation Anywhere to Microsoft Teams. So in order to take the input from the user and then want to send that text which is taken from the user to Microsoft Teams as a notification, the steps that you need to follow are from the prompt package. So from the prompt package, drag and drop the action that is prompt for value. So drag and drop prompt for value action from the prompt package and in the input properties or in the properties section in the prompt window caption, pass in the text as enter the text. And the same thing we will write in the prompt message. And then we'll store the output in a variable that is v user input. And then we will click on create and select after giving the name to the variable. So once you click on create and select, then you need to click on the save button. So now this variable we will pass in the parameter section of the API that we have called. So in the API, go to the API that you have called and over here pass in the variable that is. So we will pass in the variable that is v user input and then click on yes insert. And then we can put this variable in double quotes if needed. And then click on the save button. And then now we will run the bot in order to see that whether the text that we have given in the prompt is being sent to Microsoft Teams as a notification or not. So let us wait for the bot to run. So once the bot is run, once the bot starts to execute, it will give us the prompt wherein we will be entering the text that we want to give. So the bot has started its execution and the prompt has come wherein we will be entering the text that we want to send as a notification to the Microsoft Teams. So over here we will send the text as below are the details. And then over here we will pass in the name that is Ramesh. We will send the company that is ABC. And then we will click on OK. So once you will click on OK, the API service or the API will be called with the API will be called and the notification will be sent to the Microsoft Teams. So let us go to the Microsoft Teams in order to see where in order to see whether the details are being sent or not that we have given in the prompt. So yeah, if you go to your Teams channel and see, so the details have been sent that we gave in the prompt. So this is how you can take the input from the user and then send it as a notification to your Microsoft Teams. So with this, we have come to the end of our video discussion wherein we saw how to add incoming Webhook connector to Microsoft Teams and how to configure it once it is added. And also we saw the practical implementation of sending notifications to Microsoft Teams using Automation Anywhere A360 version. So if you have any queries regarding this video, then you can raise your queries in the comment section and I will be more than happy to answer all your queries. So last but not the least, before we wind up our session for the day, I request every one of you to please subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the notification icon so that you can receive all the latest updates and notifications that we keep posting on our YouTube channel. Thank you all and have a great day.